Hello everyone, I'm Ivana and I'm a modeling engineer. I will show you the demo of a 48 volts BMS system connected to Typhoon HIL BMS test stand. In this model we have 12 battery cells connected in series with simple model of a battery charger. Also we have current and voltage back measurements included in this circuit. This is a very detailed battery cell model. Besides basic parameters, we have diffusion process, voltage hysteresis, balancing circuit, and some additional measurements included. This battery cell has two inputs. First one is temperature. We can set three different temperatures from our SCADA. First temperature is for the first four cell, the next one is for the next four cell, and so on. Second input into the battery cell is balancing current that is coming from the BMS on our analog inputs. Here we are setting the power supply for the Orion BMS and we are receiving some values on our analog and digital inputs, such as discharging and charging limitations that are inputs in our model of a charger, and some others such as charger safety, charger enable, and other ones. Okay, HIL and BMS are connected through CAN communication. So here we have some CAN bus receivers, and these values from the BMS we will monitor in the SCADA. This model is already up and running in SCADA, so let me just open it. Okay. Here you can see this is the trace graph, and it's showing a state of charge that's being estimated by our model. And here you can see the same value that is coming from the BMS through CAN. So this is the value of the state of charge, 70%, that is being estimated by the BMS. And okay, here are the all 12 battery cells. For each cell, you can override state of charge, state of health, voltage, and you can monitor terminal voltage, internal resistance, cell state of charge, and also for each cell you can insert fault, such as a shorted cell, disconnected cell, and weak cell. Okay, for now, current is 0 amps, but I will try to discharge my battery pack with 12 amps. So you can see the discharging process. Okay, it's slowly decreasing, and you can monitor here what is the actual current, because we are included in the model limitations that BMS is being calculated. So for discharging, limit is 30 amps and I put 12. So the actual current is also 12. And you can see that this state of charge value and this one are pretty much the same. Okay, I'll put negative current for charging. You can easily monitor voltage and current. Okay, in the temperature settings, you can set temperatures, and you can monitor through CAN what are the high and low temperature. So if I check here the high temperature from this group of general faults, I put for high temperature to be 57 Celsius. So if I check this, the high temperature that BMS is detecting is also 57 degrees. Okay, I will uncheck it. check if there are some code errors. There are not. And also, Orion has their own software. So this is not our software. This one is not ours. This is the Orion's BMS software that I'm connected via RS232. And in live cell data, I can monitor all cell voltages, and I can see that 3.9. I can see, for example, in fourth cell, that is 3.9 also. Okay. So here you can see in a battery profile, cell settings, balancing settings, I put start balancing if at least one cell is above 4 volts. So when I want to trigger the balance, for example, I will show you in our scope, I put balancing current of the first cell. You can see what is the resolution, and it is zero amps. And now I'll trigger the balance with overriding the voltage of the first cell. So I put 4.2, and when I check this, terminal voltage of the first cell is 4.2. And we will wait for this LED to be red, like now, to indicate a balancing. And in our scope, we can see that balancing is active, and the peak of the balancing current is around 130 milliamps, because the resolution is 50 milliamps. Okay. Now I will uncheck it to stop the balancing. And whenever you insert a fault, the BMS is starting again to estimate state of charge. So you can see now that it is being restart, and now the estimated state of charge from our model and the BMS is not the same. And you will need full cycle of charging or discharging the battery pack to get these values synchronized again. Okay, I'll show you, just to clear all the code errors, just in case. Okay, here we can see that there is no error. And also in the Orion software, we can see here in the live cell data that trouble code detected is zero also, and balancing is still active. In the Orion software is indicated that the BMS is in balancing, and also here. Okay, but it will stop probably in 1 minute. Okay, I will now insert fault, for example, short cell. It means that I will force 0 volts on the terminals of the first cell. So for now it's 3.9, but when I short the cell, it will be zero. And you will see that fault is inserted and this red cell is indicated. And also here you can see that low voltage cell fault is being detected. And also in the Orion's software, trouble code detected one. Okay, I will just uncheck it. Put this to discharge to get synchronized state of charge again. Okay, clear again code errors just in case. Okay, you can see how voltage decreased and how state of charge decreased. Okay. and you can see decreasing in the voltage and also red cell. Here you can see weak cell fault, cell voltage of over 5 volts. Okay. Okay, it's unstable because of the fault. Okay, I will uncheck it. Okay, so I showed balancing, some fault insertion, and that will be it from my side, and thank you everyone for attention.